One single alpha motor neuron supplies to the number of muscle fibers in the skeletal muscle is known as motor unit. And we have number of motor units in the one single muscle belly. And in this illustration, I just showing only three motor units and their respective muscle fibers, how they innervate with the different colors in the extrafusal fibers. In other words, skeletal muscles. And we have large motor neuron and small motor neurons. One motor neuron can supply or can innervate as many as 1,000 muscle fibers in the muscle belly is known as large motor neuron, is usually seen in the thigh muscle of our body, whereas small motor neuron can innervate as many as 10 muscle fibers known as small motor neuron, seen in the essentially extraocular muscles. And the large motor neurons are meant for the gross movements, and whereas fine movements and coordinated movements are achieved by the small motor neuron. Required strength of the muscle belly can be achieved by the gradual recruitment of the motor unit, different motor units. This is how the strength of the muscle can be generated upon the recruitment of various motor neurons. So these recruitments of motor units can be achieved by the two ways. One is the spatial recruitment and second one is the temporal recruitment of the motor unit. So under the spatial recruitment of the motor unit, so the small and large motor units gradually recruits together in order to achieve the required strength in the muscle or force in the muscle belly. Whereas under the temporal recruitment, the consecutive recruitment of motor units over a period of time could be fused together and achieves the maximum strength.